So we have been looking at various causes that cause coastal erosion, many natural processes like wave energy and longshore drift and so on. And there are human activities which are making it worse. We talked about sea level rise and coastal structures, loss of mangrove forests and so on. And on land, land use change like deforestation, dams and other things. Hard stabilization are basically structures that are built to decrease coastal erosion, and they try to prevent the sand movement, which actually can deplete the beach of sand and make it less attractive to tourists. They are also called armoring of the shore. Okay, obviously, like many things we do with good intentions, tend to have unintended consequences, some of which are not very good. So let's look at the major types of stabilization structures. Groins and groin fields, jetties, breakwaters, and seawalls. I think you have heard these terminologies probably before, especially if you have lived in the West, lived near water, and so on and so forth, or if you've been using a boat to go out of the coast and come back, etc., right? So groins and groin fields, which means just lines of groins, are basically built of this material called riprap, and it's other large blocky material which is strong enough to withstand the force of the water and the waves, right? So it is meant, remember we talked about waves coming in, having this zigzag motion with swash being at an angle and then backwash coming down with gravity and creating a longshore transport, and that would create a loss of sand here. So somebody comes along here and says we will prevent the longshore drift of sand by putting a groin like this, and naturally what would happen is that what happens is that sand begins to pile up against the groin. So the natural flow of sand to this side is prevented. So you're going to have erosion on the other side, and the downstream end is going to be affected negatively, right? So not a good idea. Nonetheless, you can see here the impact very clearly. You have a long groin field here, and you can see the pattern. So drift is probably this way. It's building up here, building up here, building up here, and so on and so forth. Obviously, over time, it would grow enough on this side to flow over, grow enough on this side to flow over, and so on and so forth. So nonetheless, you can see there is a narrower beach here, and the beach gets somewhat better in this direction as the sand movement is changed, the natural sand distribution is changed. There is no additional sand on the beach. You are just kind of rearranging the sand from one place to the other. Okay, jetties are more protected areas, typically for parking boats behind them and so on. So you have an example of a jetty here. So here are the groins that we looked at. You can see there is erosion happening because the flow is along shore direction of the drift is here. So sand is going to build up here, build up here, build up here. And as I said, it can build up and grow over to this side, right? So you're just going to change the dynamics, the time scales of the sand movement. Jetties are built also perpendicular to the shore. They are typically built in pairs to create kind of a passageway and a wave shadow behind. So these are protected harbor entrances. Harbor, rich people living with their boats, right? So people enjoy the water, they want to have boats, and they want to prevent the boats from getting knocked around by the waves, so they want a protected area, so they build these jetties. But there are a couple of examples we'll look at which create problems. So here is the jetty at Santa Cruz Harbor in California. And you can imagine which way the flow is. It's completely starved here. It's piling up here. So longshore drift is in this direction. And this is a real life situation. This is not like a cartoonish thing we saw here, right? So the sand would build up and then would come into the harbor. Eventually, they had to set up a system to take sand out of here and pump it on this side. But Santa Cruz, for those you know, is full of rich people who want to have their boats. You can see nice houses right on the water. These are prime properties that cost a lot of money. So they spend their money and they use their harbor. They have set up a pumping system to remove sand that flows around the jetty into the harbor. Okay? Good for them, right? The other kind of structure is called breakwater, which is the jetty is attached to the land, right? Whereas breakwater is creating a wave shadow by putting a structure, a barrier ahead away from land. So the wave energy is damped and you create a wave shadow here so you can see the boats parked. Knowing the wave energy, you can design it properly so that the wave height and is severely damped inside. Okay, so they are built parallel to the shoreline and they are designed to protect the harbor from waves. Which bring energy and cause erosion, but they can cause excessive erosion and again requiring dredging to keep the area stable. And there are examples, so this is the breakwater of Santa Barbara, which was accumulating sand and was coming into the Santa Barbara Harbor. So they built a pier and then a dredge which would take out the sand and dump it on the other side because the natural direction of longshore drift was perturbed by this breakwater built this way. So this is not exactly parallel to the coast, but you can see that it was designed to prevent the longshore drift bringing salt into sand into the harbor, but obviously over time it stopped working, but then they built this to pump out the sand just like in Santa Cruz. The other example is the breakwater of Santa Barbara here, which actually got destroyed in the 1983 storm. So it was built between 1931 and 1949. It disrupted the longshore transport of sand. Here is the pier. So here is the pier again with the breakwater. So the damage, wave damage to the pier was to be reduced by creating this breakwater. Breakwater does exactly that. It breaks waves and reduces wave energy coming into the harbor. But you can see that the longshore drift has accumulated sand over here. So that was going to be a problem, but they had figured out again to pump it out. But 1983 storm wiped it out. What was special about 1983? You can use your knowledge here. What brings storms to California in the winter? The El Nino, right? So 1982-83 was a massive El Nino, so probably the winter storm which destroyed the breakwater was related to the 1982-83 storm. Okay, so those are the kind of stabilizing, hard stabilizing structures. We will look at the alternatives to hard stabilizing structures and then look at seawalls where people want to live close to the coast, but they have to pay a price for it.